Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Babcock, and welcome to week two, Features of Historiography in our BI 6625 Historiography class. Our goals this week are to demonstrate an understanding of the basic literary features and theological themes of the historical books, and to explain how Old Testament historiography is different from other OT or New Testament genres. We're looking at narrative, but looking at historiography, there are a couple of components that we want to tease out that are kind of unique as we look at historical books. To defend a position on the nature of biblical historiography as a depiction of the past, and to explore how point of view functions in the writing of Ruth specifically. So in our assignments, in assignment 2-1, how are the historical books different? And this is a video assignment if you choose to do so. In a 6 to 8 minute video or a 3 to 4 page paper, explain how the historical books are different from other books in the Old Testament or the New Testament. Consider this question from a variety of angles: their subject matter, the process of interpreting them, theological themes, and how they are applied to the Christian life. So you'll notice some of these have to do with the books themselves, and some of them have to do with their application in the modern church. Draw from the readings, draw from prior learning, draw from outside research. Your video should demonstrate organization and clarity of communication. So as we look at these, whether it's the video on the one side or whether it's the paper on the other, I'm looking for solid academic research and citations as you move through this material. So this is not just what do I think about, but what have I researched about this topic. The video is somewhat daunting and maybe a little harder because you have to be in front of a camera like I'm doing right now. You have to have your notes. You have to know what you're going to talk about. And yet, even though it may be a little harder, it's likely the most rewarding as well. It's good practice. Each of you is going into a ministry setting where you're going to be in front of people you know and often people you don't know in both formal and informal settings. And so every chance that we have to practice makes us better. So I encourage you to consider the 6 to 8 minute video. Now on the paper, I don't mark one better or worse than the other. If you choose to do the paper, that's fantastic. Just make sure it is a thoroughly researched and supported paper. Now for assignment 2-2, History, Science, or Art is a blog post, and I want you to assess what Long means when he says historiography involves a creative, though constrained, attempt to depict and interpret significant events or sequences of events from the past. Now, in a discussion post this week, one of the students actually brought this up, which is, how do we know or how should we know how to interpret the history aspect of this historiography? And this week we begin to get into that and dive a little bit more into, is it possible to have hyperbole in narrative, or is that a no-no? So when God says something, or God inspires an author to write, can God inspire the author to write using modern poetic terms like hyperbole? To fully assess what he is saying, you will need to interact with his argument in support of this thesis. That means you're going to need to read Long carefully. You're going to need to outline what he is saying, and then through your own research, do you agree or disagree with what Long says? I am also looking for biblical support in your discussion. And this is due next Monday at midnight. No discussion post this week, so just these two assignments. Last thoughts, please put your name in the file name of assignments. It is helpful if you put assignment 2-1 Babcock or your name in there, because if I do download it, it helps me to keep straight whose paper I'm looking at by the file name. As always, call me or email me with questions. Several people have reached out. I think some people discovered I don't always check the discussion post faculty questions as quickly as I address emails. So if you have a question, please email me. That way I'll see it immediately and perhaps not wait till the next day or even 2 days before I go in and look at faculty questions on Blackboard. Have a great day. I appreciate all the hard work this semester. Week two has some really interesting questions for you to explore, and I look forward to seeing what you come up with.